Hey guys, welcome back. In today's video, I will show you how I painted this little cloud study here. Yeah, starting here to mix the color for the underpainting, more or less. I'm just using those five colors here, left side, and yeah, you can see basically just kind of a darker bluish color that I'm applying for the upper part. It's a bit lighter bluish color that I'm applying on the lower end. And then it's basically just a paint around. I'm leaving the space open for the body of the cloud, more or less. Of course, some blending on top. This lighter blue and this darker blue color here. And oh, by the way, this video here is available as a full-time tutorial on my Patreon. I think over 2 hours of in-detail painting. Link is somewhere down below here. Then I basically start to build up the main body, the cloud, as you can see here. And I already start to do it in kind of a blended way, more or less. You want to have the other way around. I see people painting clouds and they very often paint them like they were kind of cut out, not really connected with the background. This is something that I really already tried to do when I build up the first layer, the base volume of the cloud, more or less. Now you see we already have put in the volume, more or less, and I already also start to build up the edges, especially on this lighter area here. By just blending the blue of the background with the whiter color of the cloud body itself, and really make sure that you wipe out the brush in between very often, so that you don't get this bluish color too much into your color of the cloud body itself. It's the set of brushes that we're gonna use for the second layer. The painting is dry now completely. You see brushes getting smaller. Colors a bit, you will see later on, a bit darker in overall. And here I'm zooming in to show you one of the details, one of the key parts. When it comes to painting clouds, you want to have those fuzzy edges, extensions, more or less. They are, I would say, really essential for realistic cloud painting. Therefore I constantly mix around color, getting darker, getting a bit lighter, really trying to build up this fuzzy, this extension character that we have here, the cloud. Also this kind of melting into the background, kind of here and there. For example, this part, it's basically dry brushed into the background and really kind of fades out in some areas. And this is something that people really kind of always do wrong, more or less. Here I'm adding some more extensions. You see, I don't have any fresh color on the brush. I'm just using this tip of the brush that basically deloads from the color and starts to help me putting in the color very thin, very not so thick, kind of. This is one of the key parts. This outer parts of the clouds, and I think the main Part here is the volume. You need volume, you want to have volume in your clouds. And therefore, now for example, I get in a bit of a darker color and start to hint those little layers that we have here, more or less. You see the colors a bit darker than the one we applied before. And when you hold your hand over the lower end, you will already start to get a feeling for the cloud that it kind of starts to emerge, kind of starts to really become 3D. And this is another thing that people very often do wrong. They put the color in kind of flat and really try they just forget about this volume aspect that clouds need to have. And the same goes for this here. I applied now this darker color on the outside, this area here, and then I kind of go back and add some lighter color here again to reshape the cloud, to really get in the volume that you need. And this is the thing that people kind of always do wrong and always kind of mess up. And keep this in mind when it comes to painting clouds. This is so important. Can't really stress this enough. Here I'm mixing kind of a lighter tone again. You can see here. And blending this lighter tone here into the darker tone we have in the back. And this first kind of layer. It's a very, when you get used to this process, it's very, kind of easy. When you think of clouds in kind of layers, more or less. But it's really, it needs to make this click to really, kind of grasp this idea of the volume. And here now, I know, and I forgot to switch off the autofocus, therefore we have this blurring effect, more or less. But I think you still see what's going on here. That I'm kind of outlining this area here with also some smaller parts here. I'm trying to connect the darker color with the bit lighter one. It's really that simple, just putting in these darker colors, of course with lots of variations here and there, some a bit more grayish, some bit more bluish, a bit more red one. Basically establishing the location of those areas, more or less, and then I fill it with some lighter color to really work out this volume. And this is, I think, twice the normal speed that I usually paint. Of course, I'm not that quick painting in real life, but you see, it doesn't take too long to build up volume in clouds. And even though you don't really see this blurry effect here, the moment I have lighter color, you can see in the sharp moments more or less the result of it, and yeah, it's a really basically a very 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 easy process. Yeah, sometimes going back, lighting up again some areas here and there. But it's really kind of all about this volume, and yeah, you can see here I'm getting pretty light in the front area, and this also helps to bring this area to the front. That the darker ones are more in the back, and this lighter one here is more in the front. And this really, I wish that people would really start to think about this and to really try to grasp this idea. Because cloud painting is basically, when you get this principle, it's really easy. Yeah, the next kind of very important step. Clouds need to connect with the background. I said this before in some other videos, but yeah, I will stress this here again to really make sure that people, that you guys out there really understand this. And next time you do a cloud painting, you really start to connect the cloud body with the background. I mean, not overall in all the places, but do it in some areas. When you're unsure, check your reference photo where you have to connect those areas. But it's really, again, this simple. Connect the cloud body with the background. And then it's really starting to really come together and become a very, kind of easy way of building up volume in clouds and connecting the cloud body with the background in those areas that need this connection, this foundation, this space. And then you basically can mock up clouds on your own, more or less. That's what I did here. I used a reference photo, but this kind of was, I went away pretty far from the original photo in this case. I mean, yes, the rough base shape is still there, but the detailed parts are quite a bit different. Again, here I'm building up the volume, this 3D effect that you want to have. And it requires quite a bit of a fine-tuning here and there and readjustment. Take your time and really get the feeling for it, where you need to add some more darker colors, lighter colors here and there. And I think when you got this principle once, then you are able to really make a great cloud painting like this one here. That's it for today, but before you leave, make sure you check out one of these other two cloud painting tutorials here.